Remix. Off the corner with the money, I got a bird sign.
Cut that shit up, Quay.
St. John, put on Hendrix.
Totally be a millionaire.
Rose, I walked in the corner with the body screaming, daughter. Never sold it back, but looking like Pablo in the floor. This gon' make me feel the way like Tony Kilmanoli.
Alright, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. It's your boy Chili Gains. So, I came to the gym today. Obviously, I had a week off last week with COVID. But this week is my squat day. So, I'm straining legs today. I was going to do 160. I think I was going to do 5x5, so 5 sets of 5. I was well rested. Obviously, you guys know about the hip pain that we're dealing with when I'm squatting. So, today, when I started warming up, I didn't do 2 minute hip stretches, I just went straight to the walk. Did a couple of things to like loosen up a bit. Started squatting and I have zero pain, like zero hip pain in my hips. And I didn't realize how much of a limiting factor that had been to my training until now. Like I can just drive up as hard as I can without having to worry about the pain being the limiting factor. So now I've got 200 kg loaded up in the bar. I did 180 before, what did I do before this?
170.
I did 170 before this and it flew up. I'll put the video on this video, or the clip. and yeah, I'm gonna go for I've done 200, sorry. I did 200, this is 230. I did 200 before this, that also felt very comfortable. Heavy on my back, but when I actually squatted it was easy. So I'm gonna go for 230. I haven't gone this heavy in such a long time. I'm gonna see how this feels and then we're gonna go from there. I'm gonna get a top single. Just to prime myself because I haven't actually gone that heavy squatting in this prep, and I'm gonna go down and do some work and then yeah, let's see how we get on, guys. I think 230 should be quite well. Let's go. Wasn't the smoothest in the world, so I feel I need to refine that a little bit more, especially as I get onto the heavier weights. But at the very least I'm happy that I've got to that 230 because I haven't touched that weight in a long time. But now I need to start playing around getting some rep work in around the 200 190 range, because that's how I'm gonna get this stronger over time. And obviously now that I know that if my hip is hurting, I just need to basically rest it for a while. I believe what I had was glute tendinopathy. And when you have that, you're not actually meant to be doing too many stretches at all. You're meant to just give it a bit of a rest and do kind of like some dynamic strengthening exercises that aren't too intense. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm gonna probably do some like one or two sets of back down and then move on to other leg exercises.
When it's real life, rich still dodging that bus right. From the west side, we don't shit slide, we on trip time. Seen the field and ain't live. Can't be serious with no rappers. Stay down and what happened? Got my daughter that mansion. Gave my mother that million. Sold my soul to my feelings. Can't go blind by these women. Too many M's to make, too many rules to break.
Yo, what's up everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I've got a deload week on deadlifts. Obviously I hit a massive PB, 302.5 2 weeks ago. Obviously I had COVID and I had a deload week, so today's my first deadlift session back. There's no point of going too high, I just need to deload. I wouldn't be able to do that high of a weight anyway because I just did 230 in squats a couple of days ago. I've got a top single on of 215 for two reps. I've just done 180. It felt pretty good, so I've got 200 loaded up, and I'm about to do my first set. Please leave a like down below, and also leave a comment down below, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. And yeah, let's have a good session. I'm about 3 weeks out, I'm feeling good. Today, you can probably tell my energy is not as high as it normally is. I'm pretty tired, I'm not really feeling that great, but these are the sessions that count, and these are the sessions that you have to put the work in regardless, and that's what I'm gonna do, so. Yeah, leave a like down below and comment down below, guys. Let's get to work. So something I really love doing after my back day is heavy shrugs. You have probably seen me do it in loads of videos before, but it's really good at building a thick back and just helping out with the deadlift lockout. I would definitely recommend adding this to your routine. So I'm actually very, very happy with the way bench is going at the moment. This is the bench session I did after that back session, and I managed to hit a top single of 160 for 5 reps. Warming up, I did 150 and this absolutely flew up, so my bench is in a very good position at the moment. Everything is coming together nicely. So for this particular set that you see me taking in some deep breaths for, I actually used my leg drive with my toes, because I've been playing around what actually do I find comfortable, more comfortable with my toes, or do I like having it flat. And so I leg drive with my toes for this set, and I got 3 reps, and then in the next set you see me leg driving with the whole of my feet on the floor, and I actually think I prefer that, especially as I've got these new weightlifting shoes, which allows you to be able to get a little bit more plantar flexion, which basically means your toes are pointed down a little bit more at an angle, and I think that position allows you to activate my quads and my leg muscles a little bit more from the floor, and I'm able to get a really good leg drive from this position more than I would if I was only leg driving on my toes, which is strange because I actually used to prefer it beforehand. So I'm going to keep doing this and get used to it, and I think moving forward I'll be benching with my feet flat on the floor, and I'm going to try and get used to this. Alright, so that's the end of the video. As I'm editing this video, I've only got 5 days till my competition, so I've got a few videos and backlog that I still need to upload. Please leave a like, comment and subscribe, and share the video if you enjoyed it or get anything out of it. Show some love, and yeah, I'll meet you guys in the next video.